Hello, Beachwood Bobcats, and welcome to week one of specials. So here's a lineup for you. Every week, we're going to start with music. Then we'll go to PE to do a little activity. We'll jump into counseling. We'll go back to PE, and then we'll close with another music activity. It's going to be great. And now on to Miss Jones with some music.
Hi, everybody. Seems like a long time since I've seen you all, and I guess I'm not really seeing you now. It's a video, but hi anyway. I've missed you a lot. And I don't know about you, but it's been hard to not have my regular routines in place and to try to figure out where I'm supposed to be and when. So I've had to come up with some new ones. So I've been doing stuff like reading a lot more than I was before. Taking long walks with some good friends, and then FaceTiming with my family to stay connected and to stay close. And speaking of staying connected, one of the ways people stay connected, even when they're not physically together, is they sing together. And there's been all those Facebook and all those videos of people singing together. I'm sure a lot of you saw the people in Italy going out to their balconies and singing together. So I thought we'd sing one that all of us know. So you can sing it with your whole family, no matter how old you are. Parents, please sing along. I'm going to sing it once. You, if you know it, sing it with me. If you don't, you can wait for the second time and sing it with me the second time. This land is your land. This land is my land. California to the New York Islands, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. As I was walking that ribbon of highway, I saw above me that endless skyway. I saw below me that golden along with me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Islands, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. As I was walking that ribbon of highway, I saw above me in the skyway, I saw below me that golden valley. This land was made for you and me. This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Islands, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made. Thank you, everybody.
And thank you, Miss Jones. Now on to Mr. Wheeler for PE. Feel free to pause right now and go get some workout clothes on.
Hey, Beachwood Bobcats. Been a long time since we've seen each other. We're going to get right into it today with a little exercise. As you can see, we have 8 different exercises. We're going to do each exercise for 20 repetitions or 20 seconds, depending on the exercise, and you get a 10-second rest in between. Let's get started. Let's start with a jog in place. 20 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Halfway there, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. 10-second rest. Two, one, and let's do some squats now. Arms straight out, feet apart. And one, two, three, four, that's it, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, halfway there, keep going, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, last one, 20, 10 more seconds. And 10 seconds. Next, arm circles. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, halfway there, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. 10 seconds to rest. Woo, I'm already starting to sweat. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Time for clapjacks. Arms out to your side, raise one knee, clap underneath. Let's do 20 of those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Halfway, keep going. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Woo, 10 seconds of rest. You count this time. And 10. Windmills, legs and feet apart, arms to your side, and we're gonna go right to left and left to right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Halfway. 12, 13, 14, keep going, 16, 17, 18, 19, one more, 20, all done. Time to go skiing. No snow, no worries. Let's pretend we're on the ski slope. We're gonna hop back and forth, right to left with our feet together. Ready, go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, bend those knees, 7, 8, 9, 10, halfway, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, one more, 20, woo, 10 seconds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's do some forward punches. Bend your knees and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. 19, 20, 10 seconds of rest. Woo! 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here comes our last exercise. Jumping jacks, you know how to do those. Ready, begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, halfway, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Whew. Let's take a few deep breaths. In through your nose, blow out through your mouth. Ready. In, blow out. In, blow out. In, blow out. One more. In, blow out. I'll see you guys in a few minutes for some stretches. Bye.
Hey, thanks, Mr. Wheeler, for that workout and for reminding us the importance of taking deep breaths. To be honest, I'm actually pretty nervous doing this video for you guys. It's hard when there's nobody around me to talk to. I wish I could be there in a classroom with you right now. To help me with my nerves and with all the other emotions that are going on out there today, I was thinking we could try taking some deep breaths. I know I sound like a broken record when I say that, but just as you saw with Mr. Wheeler, taking deep breaths is so important for our daily life. It helps with exercise, but it also helps with emotions like fear, like anxiety, like joy and excitement. It helps our mind stay clear. It helps our bodies calm down. So, Mr. Wheeler showed us one way to do breaths, and I'm going to show you one more. And maybe I'll show you another way another time. Who knows? There are so many ways to breathe. But it all kind of focuses on the same kind of technique, the same kind of way. So here we go. This technique is called belly breathing. It goes kind of like this. So I like to sit up straight when I do it. Get my body ready. And I take my hands and I place them on the top of my belly, kind of right here. Sometimes I close my eyes, sometimes I don't. That's up to you. But I like to take a deep breath in through my nose. And as I take a deep breath in, I'm feeling my stomach get bigger. My belly. I'm feeling my belly get bigger. That's why it's called belly breath. So I feel my belly get bigger. And then I breathe out through my mouth. As I feel my belly get smaller, I blow out through my mouth, and sometimes I make a sound. It kind of helps me visualize my breath. So I take a deep breath in, feeling my breath get bigger, and a deep breath out, feeling my belly get smaller. I do this a few times when I'm nervous or afraid or when I have too much excitement, and it helps my body cool down. It helps the oxygen flow through my body and get to my brain so that I can think clearly and calmly and get ready for the next thing that I need to do. For us, the next thing that we need to do is learn a little bit about cyberbullying. Our lives have really changed lately, and that's hard. We used to get to talk face to face. We used to get to see each other, give high fives. But now we have to communicate a lot through the internet, using cameras, or emails or phone calls. The internet can look different for a lot of us. Some of us use our computer or tablet or phone. Even game consoles are used sometimes. There are a lot of interesting people online and that we meet through social media or other forms of the internet. And some of these people can be mean. So today we're going to learn what to do if somebody is being mean. Let's first answer this question. What does mean behavior look like? Go ahead and say it out loud, and we'll see if I can hear you. I heard some people say making fun of somebody else, spreading lies, posting rude or saying rude comments about somebody else. Those are all mean things. How do you think mean behavior makes people feel? Yeah, mad, sad, hurt, angry. Those are all good answers to that question. If being mean to somebody else makes people feel hurt and mad and sad, why do you think someone would be mean to someone else online? You might be thinking, well, maybe they thought they were just joking around. You know, they weren't trying to be mean, but it came off as something very mean. Maybe they feel bad about themselves, so they were trying to make themselves feel better by making somebody else feel bad. Sometimes it's easier to say mean things online because you're not seeing the person face to face, and you don't have to deal with the emotions that come from being mean to somebody else. So, what can be done about it? The simple answer might be, well, go and tell an adult. But that's not always the easy answer. We're going to practice how to handle this the next time it happens to you or to someone you know. And we're going to do this using the STOP method. In this method, STOP is an acronym. STOP stands for S, step away from the device. T, tell a trusted adult. O, OK sites only. And P, pause and think online. While the acronym STOP is still on the screen, let's talk a little bit about what each letter really stands for. Step away from the device. If you're reading a comment or you heard something that makes you feel bad, maybe somebody was being mean, sticking around isn't always the best option. It's important to give yourself some space so that you can tell an adult you trust and think about what just happened. The next step, tell an adult you trust. Do you have a grown-up that you can go to if something like this happens? Maybe it's your parent or an older sibling, maybe the teacher. It's important to have somebody you can go to nearby while you're online, just in case you have a question about the learning or someone's being mean to you. O, okay sites only. This is more than just visiting sites that are okay. This is getting permission before you visit sites online, making sure that an adult knows what you're doing and who you're speaking to. P, pause and think. It's very important when someone is being mean to us or our feelings are hurt online that we think about the situation and what was happening. Did we understand correctly what was said? Were they really trying to be mean? This would also be a great moment to take your deep breaths. Deep breath in through your nose and out through your mouth. Taking the deep breaths will help us clear our mind and think through what just happened and how we can handle it. And having that adult there to help us will also give us that perspective that we need to handle the situation. To help us really understand the SOP method, we're going to go through a situation that could happen to any of us. And to some people, it might seem innocent enough, but to others, it could really hurt their feelings. So here goes. I got a script here. Two kids join an online chat. One of them's Bob. One of them's Janet. These names are made up just for the sake of this story. Bob says, "Hey, have you seen that new show, Fly Sweepers? It is so cool." And Janet says, "I can't believe you like that show. That's something my little brother would watch." How should Bob react in this situation? Let's remember the STOP method. Yes. First, he should step away from the device. Then he should tell an adult he trusts. He shouldn't return to that site until his parents say that it's okay to go back. And he should pause and think about the situation and what happened. Was it as bad as he thought? Were his feelings hurt? Could he have said something different at the time, to react a different way? Did he handle it the way he felt he should have handled it? During the pause and think section would be a great time to take some deep breaths and clear our minds. Let that oxygen help us think clearly and get focused and calm down. These days, we have to go online to do a variety of things like classwork. And online, you might run into somebody who is being mean to you or somebody else. If you experience somebody being mean, I hope you remember to use the stop method. I hope that learning about the stop method and cyberbullying will help you become more aware about the things that you say and type and do online. I have included some activities on Teams that you could do at home with your family or on your own to help you learn more about cyberbullying and how to stop it. As we transition back to Mr. Wheeler here in a minute, remember to take those deep breaths and stop and think about how you will be seen online from now on. Will you be the cyber bully? Will you be the one making those rude comments that you think are funny? Or will you be the one that uplifts people and helps people learn and grow and become a good digital citizen? All right, guys, I'll see you again next week for our next lesson.
Hey, welcome back, Bobcats. Good to see you again. Time for some stretches. Just like in class, follow along with me. You'll do fine. Here we go. Feet straight out in front of you. Try to touch your toes. But please, please remember, don't pick your nose. No, no, no. No nose picking. We're going to hold each stretch for about 15 to 20 seconds. Remember to breathe out as you stretch like this. And you can stretch a lot farther. Okay, that's about 15 to 20 seconds. Let's make a V shape with our legs. Try to keep your legs straight, don't bend your knees too much, and crawl out, touch your toes, and hold. Remember that breathing. As you breathe out, stretch farther. All right, excellent job. Let's leave one leg straight like it is, grab the other leg, bring it in, and we'll do the same thing. Reach out, touch that toe, and breathe out as you go down. Ah, lovely. Now let's do the other leg. Stretch it out, bring the other one in, and reach out and blow out. Hold it. Hold it. That's it. Almost there. 13, 14, and 15. All right. Let's put both of our feet together. Knees out to the side. You can even push down with your elbows. And I know some of you like to sing the song, the old butterfly song. So here we go. Butterfly, butterfly, fly so high. Butterfly, butterfly, fly so low. Butterfly, butterfly, kiss the sky. Butterfly, butterfly, nose to your toes. And remember, don't pick your nose. Mm-mm-mm. Couple more seconds. Excellent. Now let's leave one leg where it is. put the other one straight out in front of you. Grab that foot, put it over top. Hey, we have a rhyme for that one too. I think you remember. One leg straight, put the other over top. Pull that knee right under your chin and hold it very tight, tight, tight. Tight like a tiger. Hi, Jackie. I know you like that rhyme. Couple more seconds. And let's switch legs. One leg straight, put the other over top. Pull your knee right under your chin and hold it very tight, tight, tight like a tiger. Oh, that feels good after our exercises. Couple more seconds. And our last stretch. You guys like this one. Roly-poly. Lay down on your back. Pull your knees in tight. Hold on tight. And gently roll back and forth. Oh, that feels good. Especially when you're old like me. Whew. All right, boys and girls. We'll see you next week for a new lesson. We're going to have lots of cool things. I might even start Mr. Wheeler's Joke of the Week. And if you're lucky and you do a good job during our exercises and stretches, maybe I'll show you some magic tricks too. Until next week, bye-bye.
So thanks for connecting with us today. We're going to end with a song that most of you should know, and there should be lyrics or words for you to follow along with. Extra points if you can get your whole family to sing. All right, here we go. Thank you. Thanks, everybody. Before I let you go, I have two assignments for you. It should be kind of fun. First of all, I'm still planning on doing the slideshow for the end of the year, so send me any pictures you have to my school email, or if the district later on has some way that you can drop things into our teams, send them to me that way. But for now, you can send them to my school email. Your mom and dad should be able to help you with that, with my email. And they can be of anything that you're doing. Your pets, I've had some great ones of kids' pets, of sidewalk art, chalk art, anything that your family game nights. It's been kind of fun to watch what you're doing. It's great. Also, let me know what songs you're singing. Music is one way that can help you process through your feelings and to maybe make things a little bit better. So it might help somebody else too. Plus, I need at least another song for the slideshow, maybe two songs. So let me know what you're listening to. Until next time, bye.
Thanks for tuning in, and be sure to check back every week for the next episode of Specials.